All right, that's better. I'm back. Okay. So I'm going to share my screen here if I can. There we go. All right. Are you all seeing my web page now? Just give me a thumbs up if you see it. Yeah, good. Okay, good. All right. If you go to my, if you forget how to find the course webpage, just, you can go here, just Google David Backman Pitzer and you'll go to my webpage. And then there's a link to the course webpage right in the center on the bottom under current classes. I'm gonna click on that. And this is the new course webpage for the class. So I spent over last week, I spent a couple of days just going through every one of our lectures that we've got coming up for the rest of the semester and every homework assignment that we've got coming up for the rest of the semester. And they're correlated pretty well. A lot of the homework assignments are discussed in one particular lecture. So for example, on Thursday, we're gonna be looking at this user input level lecture. That's the name of the slideshow, is user input. What's on the left here, the topics that'll be covered. So we'll talk more about the input function in Python, the try except function in Python, the eval function in Python. Those are the topics there in that second column on the left. But then you'll see under homework, it says 8.4. And if you click on that, it goes right to the homework page for homework 8 problem 4. And this TT securities problem that you see here is what we'll talk about during that class day. So on Thursday, we'll talk about the TT securities problem. And that problem will be due Monday at midnight. So I've got the date there, the due date there, Monday at midnight for you all. So I hope that's clear. The class day is April 2nd. The topics are input, try, accept, and eval. The name of the slideshow is user input. The homework problem that corresponds to that, that we'll discuss in that slideshow, is problem 8.4, and then due at midnight on Monday, April 6th, is that problem. So since we've got most class days, you'll notice there's only one problem due per class day. So there's one problem, most Mondays there's only one problem due, and most Wednesdays there's only one problem due. And so I'm spreading out the lab time for those of you, hopefully, who got the message. So we'll do just an hour of lab time Monday afternoon, and then an hour of lab time Wednesday afternoon. Most people showed up to the Wednesday lab and left after an hour anyway. So that won't be a huge change. The big change is that I'm adding an hour of lab time on Monday afternoons as well. And that way you can get started on the homework problems. I texted you all about our Gruters. The college has let our Gruters, all student assistants for all classes, all student administrative assistants, the college, Pitzer College has decided that those students need to be protected as well. And they need to be able to focus on their studies. And so they don't need to be doing college work while they're dealing with the same crap that you guys are all dealing with. Now with that said, I've reached out to our Gruters and I've said, hey, if you are bored at home and want some socialization and some contact with your peers and want to just do some tutoring, even an hour a week, you know, you guys, I'm sure, will all appreciate that. And all three tutors said that they may be interested in doing that, that they may just want to tutor for fun because they enjoy helping people. So I'll keep you posted on that. We may add back some Grutering time. They've all three of them have told me that they will do it when they figure out how much time their classes are going to take and how much time they have available. But, you know, even an hour or two from each of them would, I'm sure, help you guys out a lot. So we're trying to do a lot of things to support you all. So again, I shifted my office hours to Monday and Wednesday mornings at 9 to 10:30, Monday and Wednesday mornings. So I gave you the Zoom links for those. I'm assuming you got those Zoom links since you got this class's Zoom links. So I will just be sitting there on Zoom waiting to help anybody from any of my classes who show up on Monday and Wednesday mornings. Then Monday and Wednesday afternoons from 1:15 to 2:15, I'll just again just be sitting online during our lab time. You want to just show up anytime during that hour and just ask questions or get started on the homework, that's fine. And I will just circulate around and ask answer questions. And then Monday and Wednesday at midnight, you've got homework due. So I encourage you to take advantage of all those times. And if we can get our tutors working at all on a volunteer basis, Sunday night, Tuesday night, and Thursday night, you'd have that support as well. So we'll see what we can do just to support you guys and give you everything you need. I know you're all struggling with a lot being at home, and some people have spotty internet connections. I know I've got a couple of students, I think two, who are back in China and one in India. So they're going to be watching everything remotely. So I hope we can do what we can to support you guys and let you all succeed. We've dropped a couple of things from this class to compensate for the new schedule, for missing a week of instruction. Two big things we've dropped are the second midterm is gone. So that'll save us a class day. And the final project is gone. So your grade is really just going to be based on the first exam, the homeworks, and the final exam. We'll still do a final. I still haven't figured out how to do that, but we will do that. And with that all said, I'm sure grades are something you're stressing about. Pitzer College, you should all know, is considering a motion where every single Pitzer class this semester is going to go to pass, no credit. And we'll only do letter grades under really exceptional circumstances. It's not fair to offer letter grades to some students and not others, because some students are having an easier time with things. So this whole class may just go to pass fail. So before you start worrying about what's going to affect your grade and what isn't, you shouldn't have to stress too much about those grades, since it'll just be pass, no credit. Okay. That's the most likely scenario. Even if the college doesn't do it as a whole, I'm still considering doing that. I can just make the class pass fail for everybody, but I'm going to mostly follow what other people in the college are doing. So if they all make all their classes pass fail, that's what we're going to do. And that seems likely. I'll let you know. I'll keep you posted on all that.
Can we request to get a grade, or do you have to get a certain grade to be able to request it?
No, the grade request, I think if you want a letter grade instead of pass fail, you have to request that like now. When we go to pass fail, you'll then at that point submit that request. It's not like at the end of the semester, if you're getting an A, then you can suddenly request, hey, I want that A.
Okay.
It'll have to be done now. Yeah.
Yeah. Harrison already reached out to us about the Grooters as well.
Oh, awesome. What did he say? He didn't tell me.
He just sent out an email. I didn't read it, to be honest, but it's something along the lines of that they're all volunteering.
Okay. Well, they're all volunteering. Yeah. All three of them have said they will volunteer some hours. They haven't told me what those hours will be yet, and I thought all three of them told me they have to see what their own schedule is going to be like before they figure out what hours they'll be available. Did they say something more specific to that to you guys?
Yeah, he had a meeting yesterday, I think.
Okay. Okay.
One more question. Yeah. What's there's the two videos from the last class.
Yeah.
And like you need a username and password to.
I'll go through that right now.
Those.
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah. So in the future, in fact, this what I'm saying right now is being recorded, and I will post it. In this box under slides under 331, I will post this video right now, so people who are not joining us right now can get these instructions that I'm sharing with you. Sorry, in this box here where it says video. Can you see that box being highlighted? I'm highlighting boxes on my screen. Oh, you can. Good. Okay.
Yeah,
in this box here that I've highlighted, I will post everything I'm saying right now, a video of that. I'm going to create a private YouTube channel just for you guys. And in the future, like on Thursday when I lecture, I will post that next to user input in this box right here. That lecture will get posted there in case you missed that lecture. If you're in a different time zone, you can see the user input lecture there. The Julie Madero, who's also teaching this class at Harvey Mudd, is actually a day behind us. The Thursday before we all left, she was out of town. So I gave this Designing Loops lecture to you that day, and she didn't. So instead, she recorded it and put those videos up. So rather than re-recording that video for you guys, since I already gave you that lecture, I just posted links to her video links. So where it says loops and Mandelbrot set, she broke it up into two different videos. It's just, if you were here that last class day, she's just gonna say, this is the same slide, so she's just gonna say exactly what I said that day. But she has it password protected. I sent you the passwords. Let me do this. In the chat window, I will chat to everybody the username and password. So the username was just CS5, and the password
was alien.
Was alien, A-L-I-I-I-E-N. So I'll go there and just show it to you so you all can see, first of all, that it's not me, and second of all, that it's the same. Apparently it's remembering that I already put in the password. Once you put in the password once and you have your computer remember it, then it'll just remember, should remember it, and not ask you for the password again. And my internet connection is apparently unstable.
Before break, you got the chance to learn a little bit
about loops. You all hear her talking?
While loops. And on this week's homework, we're going to get a lot of practice with those.
Yeah.
In this video, I want to tell you about two of the problems where you'll get a chance to practice loops.
Okay, I'm not going to go through it again, but this slide should look familiar from class last time.
80 of them land.
We went through the exact same algebra last time.
And myriad
and all of this stuff.
That you write. One called pi one. That we can go through, and okay. Having
again, those that we did all that stuff last time right before class. So, you know, again, it was for those of you who were there, I know it was 2 weeks ago, you may have probably forgotten everything that was said. So, you may want to just rewatch those to remind yourself. The slideshow itself, if you look under the Designing Loops link, there's this. This is the slideshow. So you'll see again the same slides, and then you can just paste through it, go through it at your own place. If you don't feel like you need to hear me or Julie talking, then you could just go through the slideshow. That's there as well. And then those problems that are discussed in that slideshow, like estimating pi by using this Monte Carlo method, those are in these problems, 8.1, 8.2, 8.3. Those three problems, one of those is that pi from pi problem. There's an extra credit problem, 8.5. Again, it's extra credit, so you don't have to do it. So tomorrow night, there are just these three problems due, 8.1, 8.2, and 8.3. The only other day we have multiple problems due is on April 13th. And again, one of those is extra credit. EC stands for extra credit. So there's only one extra problem really that day. Most days there's one problem just on that one day, 4/13, you've got two problems due. And I believe one of those two problems is super short. Yeah, this one is longer. I think it's 9.2 that's short. Let's look at 9.2. No, I lied. These will both take some time. It's not too bad, actually. This one's not too bad. 9.2, just budget some extra time that day, 4/13, when you have 9.1 and 9.2, when those are both due. They will take you some extra time. Every other class day, we just have one problem due, okay? All right. Does anybody have any other questions about how things are gonna go? Oh, let me say one thing. I emailed you all about this yesterday. I don't know if everybody saw that. The labs have always been extra credit. The labs have always been optional. You've always had this one little incentive, which is that if you show up to the lab and sign in at lab time, then you will receive automatic full credit for that lab problem. I can't do that anymore because now every homework assignment you're doing, you're gonna start in a lab if you show up to the lab. So I can't give you automatic credit for every problem from now to the end of the term just by showing up. So the way we're gonna do things, some of these homework problems you should already know, when you upload them to Gradescope, they're auto-graded. So I've also lost my graders. Our graders will do some possible tutoring, but they will no longer help me with the grading. So just to manage my workload, and I think to help you guys out, you're gonna know what your grade is immediately from the auto grader. If the auto grader says you got full credit, then you'll get full credit for that. Some of the problems, especially the ones that have been lab problems, there's no auto grader for. So you just, they, and it is even said this is a hand-graded problem. Those problems, I will give you automatic credit just for showing up. So for example, probably 8.1, 9.1, 10.1, those are probably all lab problems that you will get automatic credit just for showing up those lab days and doing. If you don't show up, sorry, let me back off. You get automatic credit just for submitting an honest attempt. You don't have to show up because we've got too many people in different time zones. So I misspoke right there. All you've got to do is upload an honest attempt to Gradescope and I will give you automatic credit for those problems. You don't even have to show up for lab anymore to get automatic credit, okay? The lab, your incentive for coming to lab is just to have me as a resource to answer your questions if you get stuck, okay? That's your real only incentive for lab. You could think of lab time now as just extra office hours time just for you guys. And so you're not competing with students from my other classes at with me having to balance you guys with them, answering questions with them as well. So lab time is an hour on Monday and an hour on Tuesday, on Wednesday that I'm going to be online just to answer your questions essentially and help you get started with those assignments. Okay. I think I've said everything now that I emailed you all about on Sakai. So you've all have gotten this information before in writing. Does anybody have any questions? You can just turn your microphone on and ask questions, or you can do it in the chat window.
Yeah, I have a question. Is there any more, like, because we used to do attendance for classes and like do the quizzes. Is that like still a thing, or is there like a variation for
That is still a thing, and I'm glad you're reminding me of that because I even wanted to do that today just to see who's here and who isn't. So what I'm about to do is I'm about to ask you all a question. Let's see if I can do this. Give me 1 minute here. I'm about to ask you a single question, and I think I can then get the attendance from this. Let's see if this will work. Save. Launch poll. Everybody see that? Oh, I'm seeing people are answering, so. Not surprisingly, nobody's saying no, they're not here. That's good. All right, so again, I mean, some people are in radically different time zones. So if you're watching this after the fact and you're in a radically different time zone, if you've already reached out to me and told me you're in a different time zone, then I will give you credit for having come to class. So you don't have to worry about attendance credit if you're in a different time zone. So this is the method by which I'm going to take attendance during class time. And again, attendance is going to be a fairly minimal part of your grade, but I'll come up with some weighting for attendance so that you get some credit for actually making it to class. If the class is pass-fail, especially, attendance probably in reality isn't going to count for a whole lot. I will not take attendance during lab time. Again, lab time is completely optional. And is really just there for me to provide help to you, in-person help to you, so that you have some advice about those homework problems. Okay. Looks like everybody but 9 people have not answered the poll. So use the chat window to, if you're having trouble with the polling feature, try to send it in a chat. And I see some people are chatting. Mark, you said, does anybody know which office to reach out to about letter grade request? And Joey said he was just going to email me. And the correct answer is me. You reach out to me for a letter grade request. And again, that's only going to be the case if the whole college goes to pass-fail. If the whole college, all of Pitzer College goes to pass-fail, then this class will go to pass-fail. And then if you need a letter grade for some reason, you've got to have a pretty good reason, to be honest. some people have been told that medical schools, in particular nursing schools, only count classes that are given for letter grades, some graduate programs. And we've been keeping track of the news. We've been in contact with a lot of people at a lot of other schools. We've been talking to some medical schools, and it looks like across the board, almost all schools are going to be looking at spring 2020, understand something was weird that semester, and accept pass no credit classes, even though they've said they'll only accept letter grade classes. So for the most part, if you think you need it for graduate school applications or something like that, probably you won't. Probably pass no credit for any class taken this semester, you find. If you look online and just do some Googling, you'll see a lot of schools across the country are going pass no credit. Brown University, even Berkeley are all going, all their classes are pass no credit this semester. Harvard Law is pass no credit only. I mean, there's a lot of schools around the country. And it may be by the end of the semester, everyone's going to realize letter grades are a bad idea this semester and just go that way just across the country. So we'll see. Okay.
Do you know when they'll be letting us know the information about what the new grading policy is? Yeah. Like when?
I think we're scheduled to vote on it as a faculty Thursday afternoon. I suspect if it happens, it'll go into effect very shortly after that, maybe even that night. So hopefully by Friday, certainly by next Monday, we should know.
All right, thanks.
And if any of you, by the way, also, if any of you, sorry, I just interrupted somebody, but if any of you prefer the pass no credit option for this class, even if the whole class doesn't go to pass no credit, all five colleges have given you the option of switching any of your classes to pass no credit. So even if we maintain a letter grade, if you want this to be a pass no credit class for you, just let me know. And I can make that change for any of you on an individual basis. But just hold off on that until probably Monday when I know whether or not the whole class is going to go that direction anyway. Other questions? Having trouble hearing that. Somebody wanna, who's ever just talking, you wanna put that in a chat?
Yeah.
Do you think it look weird on your transcripts if like you requested grades for like half your classes and the other half for like pass no credit? Or would it look better just to have like all classes pass no credit?
That's a fantastic question. That's a great question. If all your classes are pass no credit, I think any school looking at your transcript, any employer looking at your transcript will recognize, hey, that was spring 2020 and things were weird. Okay. If only half your classes go that way, I don't know.
Okay. Thanks. That makes sense.
Yeah. All right. Somebody just popped up on the chat. Michelle. Does anyone know if all five C's will likely adopt a full universal policy requiring pass-fail? I know Harvey Mudd is considering it. I don't know about the other colleges. I was told yesterday from a Harvey Mudd faculty member that they are considering it as well. I have not heard anything from Scripps, CMC, or Pomona. I've been in touch with the math departments at Scripps, CMC, and Pomona. All five colleges, their math departments, and this is true almost across the board, for all majors, generally you're only allowed to take letter graded classes for your majors. And I think all five colleges are waiving that. So if you decide to take your classes pass no credit now, even if it's a major class, it will be accepted for your major. Other questions? All right, if there are no more questions, I think during lab time, what I'm gonna do is break you up into breakout rooms. So you're in groups of, let's say groups of three. So you'll only see like three people at a time once I switched you to a breakout room. And then you can talk to those three people. You feel free to submit your homework assignments working with somebody else. You know, again, that's a way to reduce your own stress level and workload. And it's a nice way to maintain some social contact with other people is to work with them. So I think I want to start that now. Anybody who wants to just log off, I see we've already lost a bunch of people, which is fine. Well, no, let's see. I've already got two pages of people here. Anybody wants to log, just log off now and just work on your own on the homework problems during this time or later this evening. That's fine. Those three homework problems, 8.1, 8.2, 8.3, they are due tomorrow night. So if you don't want to start them right now, you could start them later. We're just going to keep working on them during lab time tomorrow. So I'm here. I'm going to sit here until 12:15 like I normally would. I'm going to, for those of you who remain, I'm going to put you into breakout rooms. And then what I'm going to do is virtually circulate around to the breakout rooms and just keep checking in. So probably every 10 minutes or so, you're going to see me pop into your breakout room and go, hey, does anybody have any questions? And I will try to set things up so that during lab time, you can share your screen too. So if you have questions, you'll be able to share your screen and I can see your code. And then I could say, hey, they're on line 12 on your code. Try to do this instead of that. Okay. So while I'm not there, again, I'm going to be circulating around virtually. So while I'm not with you in your breakout room, you're with two or three other people that you can talk to and you can say, hey, do you have any idea how to do problem one? How do I even get started on it or whatever, right? So you'll have other people you can talk to. It's a little bit hard if I keep all 50 of you in just one giant class, then it's hard for everybody to talk to everybody else. I'm gonna try that now. I'm gonna stop recording right now. So anybody who's watching at home, the recording is going to end right now.